So now that we have our images inside of Photoshop, it's time to combine the pieces of hair that we like. So just to kind of get things straight, this is the image we're going to actually use. And this here is our image that's going to be our source for the hair on the camera left side. So what we're going to do is just make a rough selection. So we're going to grab our lasso tool. You can just hit the L key for that, and that will grab it. Now, one thing you want to do is always select more than you think you're going to need, because then we can have the option of blending it, and it also makes for easier alignment. So I'm going to go ahead and select a fairly large portion here, something like that. And then I'm going to try and grab this as the division point, so somewhere in around the part here. And I think actually I'm going to just expand this a tiny bit more just to be on the safe side. There we go. So now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to feather this a little bit, although I probably don't have to because I'm going to end up feathering it later. But what we can do is hit the Q key. That's going to bring up quick mask mode. And then we're just going to go into filter, blur, and Gaussian blur and just apply a little bit of feather to that. So something like 17 pixels should be good. Hit Q again. And then we're going to hit Command or Control J. That's going to duplicate just that side for us. We're going to grab our Move tool, and we're just going to move it. So with that layer selected, we're going to move it up to our other tab, and then holding down the Shift key, we're going to release. So that's going to drop it in. Now, obviously, this works best when the two images are similar. So if you had her looking in a completely different direction, probably not going to be easy to take the hair out of there, but these are close enough that we can easily do this. So what we're going to do now is just change the opacity here so that we can kind of visualize both at the same time and get everything aligned. So we can see this is our floating part. So what we need to do is let's first of all align the top here so that the part of the hair matches from one image to the next. And then what you'll immediately notice is that there is a bit of a scale difference here. So I'm going to hit Command T to transform this, and holding down the Shift key allows us to transform it in unison both directions. So hold down the Shift key. And then we're just going to more or less align this here. So something like that should be pretty good. Now what you can do too is if you want to align anything further, you can right click it and select warp. And then with warp, we can just kind of tweak certain areas a bit more. So if we want to get the jawline, you know, maybe a little bit better aligned, we can do that. We can kind of align it in the chin a bit better, although I think it was pretty close. And then also in the part here, we can just make sure that everything is kind of coming together very similarly. So something like that. So now that I'm ready, I'm just going to hit enter there. That's going to apply that transformation. And what we're going to do is add a layer mask over top of that. Now we have to go back to 100%, obviously. And we're going to grab a brush, make sure that black is selected, and probably around 20% flow or 10% flow should be good here. Let's start with 10%. And we're going to just grab a large brush. Again, if you want to increase or decrease your flow, you can hit the Shift key and then 1, 2, 3. So if you want shift a flow of 10%, just do Shift 1, and that will give you 10% there. So essentially, we're just going to paint out these transition areas because they don't look terribly good. I'm not too concerned if I lose some of these stray hairs. In fact, I kind of want to lose them, so that's totally fine. And basically, we just want to kind of paint it until it's not really noticeable that we are blending two images together. So I think for me, whenever I do this kind of thing, I always look for transition points that make sense. Now, this kind of area here, this dark area where we don't have a lot of detail, that's going to be a good transition point, not necessarily the skin on her face. So I'm basically going to keep masking out until the dark point is our transition point. Now, here I have to keep this because this shadowing has to match. But generally, anything over here we can afford to lose from our new copy and just keep the old one. So if we kind of toggle this on and off, you can see the difference that's making there. Now you have to be careful with this too. If you use too soft of a brush, we should probably harden it up too, because if you have a lot of skin texture, you might end up softening it in those transition areas. So just be careful there. Now in this case, this is a shallow depth of field shot, so there's going to be some softness here anyways. Even if we have softness in the transition, you're not going to notice it because it's the shallow depth of field is softening it anyways. So that's fine. But if it was a beauty shot, you definitely have to be more careful there. So let's just take a look here and see up at the top whether we want to maybe refine this a little bit, which I think I do. Just going to adjust that a tiny bit. Okay, and always just toggle on and off to make sure that nothing looks weird. So it looks like, as you can see here, if we look at the mask, we still have some areas that aren't pure black. So I definitely want to make that a darker black. So let's go ahead and enlarge. Now I'm going to skip to like about 30% flow, and then we're just going to kind of aggressively paint in these areas here just to make sure that we're not doubling up and overlapping any of these two sections. Now I think I've probably gone too far in this area, so I'm actually going to soften my brush up again. Totally fine to have a soft brush here because ultimately there's no real detail here anyways. It's all very soft. So going back to 10%, we're just going to feather this in a little bit so that it doesn't look quite so harsh. Something like that. And let's just make sure everything else is looking okay. So I think I actually want to reveal a little bit in this area as well. All right, I think that's getting pretty close. So toggling that on and off, we can see there's our difference. And I think, again, I just like the fullness that we get in the hair from this, sort of these crossing lines, and now we kind of get the best of both worlds on these. So now that we've got those two merged, what I'm going to do is just hit Command-Option-Shift-E or Control-Alt-Shift-E, and that is going to flatten those two into one layer. And now we're going to work off of this layer as the basis for the rest of our editing.